Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory, finally. Actually, more like the laboratory kitchen. What you have here in front of you are all the essentials you will need for a yummy and delicious scrapple sandwich. Yes, this is the nourishment you will need if you're a styrene addict. This feeds the mind and the heart. It chokes the heart if you eat enough of it, but definitely great fuel and great fun. And more importantly, it's the recipe that you will find in our very first book at the end of it on page 113. There it is. Yes. Oh, yes. There's the recipe. Anyway, let me just walk you through quick ingredients, you know, French baguette, all right, green tomatoes, very southern, very important, Vidalia onions, yes, Vidalia onions, and more important than anything else, of course, is the infamous scrapple itself, yes, already cut, all ready to go. A good friend of mine, you know who you are, sent me this brand, which is actually a very good brand. It's the original Rapa Scrapple. Woo! Yes! Total fat, 8 grams. Saturated fat, 3 grams. But if you read that, you won't enjoy the sandwich. Of course, you serve with a pickle on the side. And with either regular mustard or the Dijon. Salt and pepper to taste. And next up, I am going to show you assembly, my friends. So, without further ado, we have the scrapple, the making of the scrapple sandwich. Yes, come on, Rapa. There we go. Original scrapple, yes. All right. All right, my friends, we're gonna fry it up. This is, if you have any questions, you could always refer back to the book or you could ask the doctor himself. All right, here we go. All of a sudden, Dr. Cranky's gonna turn into Julia Child. Hello. Oh, I do a terrible Julia Child impression. All right, we're turning the heat up to high. And then we're putting enough olive oil or butter. I like olive oil, you know. Then I season my olive oil, a little bit of pepper, and a little bit of salt. All right. And you wiggle it all around. I am going to need a spatula. Here we go. Actually, I'm going to go for a plastic spatula. And we're gonna take our scrapple, and we're gonna wait for this to be hot, and we are going to not hot enough. That happens. Then you take one and you kind of roll the oil around. It's all right. It's not hot enough. We'll make it hotter. Come on. Scrapple is one of those mystery meats that's absolutely delicious, and it's kind of earthy, nutty, livery taste to it that we love here in the laboratory, and we know that Igor is crazy about it. So, all right, there goes the oil sizzling. The idea is to not only cook it up, but you know, I like it sort of crispy on the side. So on the sides, not on the side, not like you put the crispiness on the side and have that by itself. All right, we're just going to do a few slices, which is enough. Oh, that's the sound we wanted to hear. Yes. Woo. All right. Three. Remember, when in doubt, scrapple. We were having all sorts of scrapple sandwiches way back, And the, you know, the history of it is that we decided to create a production company called simply Scrapple Sandwich Productions. In the back of my mind, I always knew that if we had a laboratory crew, we'd feed them Scrapple sandwiches, yummy Scrapple sandwiches. Now, at this time, you can, you know, if you're me, you can put a little bit more pepper and, of course, a little bit more salt. This is not heart-friendly food. Now, if you're worried about Dr. Cranky, don't be, because Dr. Cranky actually is not eating too many of these days. As it begins to get crispy, you turn it over. You want to cover both sides. Also, don't be afraid if it begins to fall apart on you because you cut it thinner than 1 1/4. That's okay. There we go. You want to fry it up. As I said, you want to fry it up crispy. And kind of to a golden brown so that it's nice and cooked and tender. And they're such thin slices anyway that they are going to break up on you, which is fine. You know, it ends up turning into a kind of a paste, which you can apply it to the sandwich, and you'll see that in a moment. But anyway, see, it breaks up, which is fine. Don't fret. And it turns into a kind of a paste. Very yummy. It's a great breakfast food with some eggs, especially if you like, corned beef hash and stuff like that. This is perfect. Anyway, we are getting ready to assemble it, so stay tuned in for that. All right, my friends, so we're at the table, and as you can see here, we've got the scrapple on the baguette. We've got a couple of pickles, delicious pickles. Now, let me tell you a little bit about the tomatoes, green tomatoes, very important. You can make them Southern style, which, you know, requires frying them. You can bread them and fry them if you so want. But that's, you know, given the nature of the sandwich, that's a little bit of overkill. All right. Then you could put in as much tomato as you want. Now, the other very important thing are these delicious Vidalia onions, which, again, you could do sauteed, and I just like to put a whole bunch of it on there. And again, this is a fortifying food, no doubt about it. Woo, that's a lot of delicious. And then we usually go for the French's mustard, you know, shake it up a little bit. Yeah, get rid of that little gunky thing that, you know, gathers. Here we go. And put a whole bunch of mustard. I love mine with a lot of mustard. And of course, you know, you can eat it with a fork and knife if you so want. Or you could just, oh yes, press on it. You can also cut it, you know, you can press it. It's just a very friendly sandwich. So there it is, my friends, the infamous Dr. Cranky's Lab-RAT-ory Keep Styrene Addicted Scrapple Sandwich, brought to you by Dr. Cranky's Lab-RAT-ory and Scrapple Sandwich Productions. That sandwich will see you through the day. You could be a bricklayer, you could be an accountant, a lawyer. You eat this in the courtroom, and you'll be the envy of the stock aides behind that holding wall. Anyway, so hope you enjoyed it. Sorry it took about 1,050 videos to bring it to you, but there it is. There it is. Eat Scrapple. And thank you for supporting Dr. Cranky's Lab-RAT-ory all these many years. There'll be more styrene addiction and fun headed your way, my friends. All right, have fun and eat well. Nourish yourself and keep that styrene fever running high. Have a good one. Yum. Hey everybody, we've got the sandwich finally. We want to thank you for the support and for watching. And just in case you were wondering, oh sure, he makes the sandwich, but we don't see him eating it. Oh yeah, nothing like a sandwich that falls apart. My mouth is watering. Oh, fantastic. Wow. Just what the doctor ordered. All right, my friends. Remember, feed your styrene addiction, stay nourished, and keep on building. Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory, about to go in for another bite. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.